Well, Gibbs today was asked about that, White House Press Secretary Robert Gibbs, and his argument was that when the Taliban and related insurgents have the momentum, as everyone agrees is the case in Afghanistan right now, it doesn't make any sense to argue that if the U.S. starts talking about exit dates, that they're going to start waiting out the U.S. And lay down their arms, because they are on the offensive right now. The battle is joined, and so that argument might make sense if it were a different situation where the Taliban and al-Qaeda were just lying in wait, but they're not. They're on the offensive. So that's their pushback on that.
Before I go back to Jeff, on health care, does the administration feel that they had no choice, or do they look at the way it has happened and think, we wish we had deferred?
I think that if you got a couple drinks in them and told them that you were off the record, you might hear them talk about perhaps not pushing so hard on climate change legislation in the House earlier this year. But generally speaking, I don't think that they feel they made any major mistakes. It's a sloppy legislative process, and it's not easy to do. If it were easy to do, it would have happened a long time ago. I think they feel pretty good. Just even as ugly as the situation has been, this is empirically farther than anyone has got in decades when it comes to reforming health care.
Jeff, let me turn a little bit to the overall impression of the president. Maureen Dowd, the columnist for your paper, had a column in which you said he seems static. Others have said, Tom Friedman, also a columnist, has said there is no narrative that has been articulated well. What's the overall impression that is present at the White House?
I think the overall impression is that there's, one, a sense of weariness. It's been a very tough year, and the White House does not think that they've gotten really enough marks for all their accomplishments. If you look at things sort of a year ago, the economy was on the brink of a collapse, et cetera. It's still not good now, but it's not quite on the brink. The White House has had to slowly realize that this is not the campaign. The transitioning from governing or into governing from campaigning has been a challenge for President Obama. It's one of the reasons, one of the key reasons, that he will be at the West Point Military Academy tomorrow in New York announcing this. Had he been in the Oval Office, as was discussed for a while, to give this Afghanistan address, he certainly would have looked static. So what they're trying to do is bring back a little bit a sense of the campaign, a little bit of sense of him out there. But if they close the year getting some type of a health care deal, or if that happens early January, I think they will view this year as a success, and the mood will certainly go up. If something happens with that, that will really signify a deepening troubled spot for this presidency going forward. So he's not, he thought the hardest point of all this was running for president. Of course, being president is far, far harder, and he's naturally had some struggles with it.
Join us online at charlierose.com.